Okay, so the two of us have been having this debate for a long time over which is actually better, classical music, which is, you know, perfect, or pop music.
Literally no one goes to the symphony and classical music is dead. So, like, should we just end the video?
Okay, no. We're gonna debate this with science. First things first, and I know this is very important to you, near and dear to your heart. Classical music is better for your health. It actually helps people with chronic pain, sleep disorders, and a variety of issues. In fact, a 2006 study found that students who went to sleep using classical music actually had better sleep quality than those who didn't.
Yeah, I guess I won't argue that classical music puts you to sleep. Okay, so that study you talked about, they also talked about how they just listened to music to help them with their chronic pain that they liked. Okay, so music that they liked. A lot of that music ended up being pop music because pop music is
what people like.
Speaking a lot about health, and pop music also has a lot of positive health effects.
Like
and,
what?
Well, listen, fMRI studies show that the reward circuits of your brain light up when you listen to songs that you've heard before. The mirror exposure effect, that's the thing that you love. You like things that you're used to. That's why you hear New Rules in the car. Then you like it when you hear it at the club. Well, whereas classical music is played less in cars and at clubs, so in general you like it less, and therefore your reward centers fire less in fMRI
that's
studies
because
show
pop music's just
that health benefits are from pop because you know it better.
No, pop's just the lowest common denominator. They don't play classical music on the radio because it's too...
People will fall asleep at the wheel, I know. Know what else could potentially make you live longer?
What?
Working out. Oh. And know what the best way to work out is? Listening to pop jams. Not, what is the name of a classical composer?
Like Chopin.
No one is bumping to Chopin in the gym, let me tell you that. So studies show that those who were actually allowed to listen to music while working out lost more weight than those who weren't, likely because those pop jock jams were getting the people going.
Okay, well, if you listened to my first point, you would have known that classical music already has great health benefits, including stuff related to abdominal fat and feeling better. But on top of that, it's worth mentioning that pop music is actually based on chord progressions from classical music. So basically, everything that you like is just a simple derivative version of what was already created. And not to mention, most pop songs just sound the same anyway.
It's not 1860s, and we all don't have weird things in our hair. We're not like sexist, horrible people who are going to listen to all these men write music. I like my female pop stars. Yeah, that's right. I went there.
Let's go look at the pop charts right now and see who's at the top.
Oh god.
Shall we? How many girls versus men?
Number one, Camila Cabello.
That says number one, Drake.
Okay.
Number two, Post Malone. Number three, Drake. Okay, then we have
BB Rexha.
So, okay, there's more
no,
boys
right.
than
there's
girls.
A lot of
so,
them.
Okay, classical music.
Everything is a derivative of something else. Every beautiful movie you saw, in many ways, was just what Shakespeare thought, or something. People say, I don't really know. People just say, but you can't deny the beauty that is Justin Bieber's. What do you mean? Yeah, that's right. 2016. Here we go. What do you mean?
No, wait. We can't play that because if we play it, we'll literally get flagged on YouTube. But what we can do is jam out to some classical music because it's in the public domain, which means it's usable.
So
and not
old.
Flaggable. So
that's how you dance. You hug. I actually have Scooter Braun on speed dial, so we could get it for her.
Also, it's interesting that you brought up What Do You Mean, because an NYU study actually found that students who prefer songs like What Do You Mean or No Diggity actually scored higher on psychopathy testing, meaning you're probably a psychopath.
Yeah, there was like mad confirmation bias in that study for sure. That makes
Wait, what?
No sense.
No, I can see it.
If you're gonna make blanket generalizations like that with that study, then I can do the same because the study found that people who like pop music are more gentle, more outgoing, and more hardworking. So maybe we're actually not.
Well, that exact same study found that pop listeners are actually less creative and not as at ease, while classical listeners...
Ooh, sorry, I was just yawning. Keep going.
So, insecure is another trait we could probably add. But classical listeners are actually more confident and they tend to be introverts. Classical listeners are more vulnerable, meaning they have better communication in their relationships. Sounds familiar,
I'm
huh?
I'm so good
Sounds
at communicating.
Sounds familiar, huh?
Contrary to popular belief, you don't need to have good communication if you're rich and smart. There was a study that found of 1,600 people that the people who were the richest and the most educated listened to reggae, hip-hop, blues, jazz, and pop.
Wait, no, it said classical on that list. I looked at that. Literally, that study showed that classical listeners, especially when they listen to Mozart, their IQ would increase by 10 points. I mean, it didn't necessarily last forever, but there was somebody
who knew it.
I mean, like, they weren't smarter by 10 IQ points forever, but they actually showed an increase in their temporary IQ after listening to Mozart. That's pretty amazing.
I guess. I'm sort of like posted chilling with this argument because I feel like, again, in the end, classical music is dead. Sing it with me, everyone. Classical music is dead.
Okay, well, you know what's not dead? Anxiety and depression.
In the arms of the angel.
Classical music has a good effect on calming people because the rate and the speed of classical music tends to be closer to the heart.
But no one's listening
people.
To it.
Yeah, but if they did, it could save your life.
Yeah, well, it currently makes up less
we
than 3%.
Percent,
less than 3% of the music market is classical music.
Sorry, and was this debate about which one's more popular? Because I didn't think that's what we were talking about. I thought we were talking about which is better.
Ho ho ho!
Classical music is, you know, all over the world, coming from different nationalities. I think it's time that you guys let us know what you think wins, classical or pop. Again, we're not talking
about
popularity.
But they're just gonna say pop because they don't even know what classical music is, because a lot
of people. We'll see. We'll put two different comments in the description. One will say classical, one will say pop, and we'll upvote them.
If you're learning the piano, which song would you rather learn? The B goes to the thing by Chopin or the newest Coldplay song?
Yeah, I think the answer is pretty clear in that example. Okay, let us know what you think. Otherwise, we hope you enjoyed our little debate. Let us know what you want us to debate next, because basically we have opposite opinions on everything.
I know,
it's pretty easy for us to just like come together. But yeah, if you like this, give it a thumbs up. Otherwise, subscribe.
I have to go pee.
We'll see you next time. Bye.